नमस्ते. नीतिकृतनियमरहितां ख्यादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् इन् द सप्तमोल्लास वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् दोषास् एण्ड् वि डिड् टिल् अप्रतीतत्वं लास्ट् टैम्. लेट्स् मूव् आन् टु द नेक्स्ट् वन् विच् इस् ग्राम्यम्. Yeah, we did this. Gramyam, where the words he uses are not a very, let's say it's not very sophisticated words that the poet uses. If he doesn't use any sophisticated words, and if it is very uncultured words, then it is called Gramya Dosha. So for the Padagatam, we saw he used the word katihi. Katihi is normally not used for ladies. We use Nitamba or Shroni and other words. There are other Paryayavachi words which you can use for a more sophisticated expression or a cultured expression. Whereas katihi, you find for men, poets have used, like Shankara has used the word kati for Subramanya and all that. And even in Krishna Karnamritam, he is used for Krishna. So not, you generally don't use that word for women as indicating the waist or the hip. Now here for the Vakyagatam, he uses, now as I told you, Padagatam means only if the dosha exists in one pada, it is called Padagata dosham. If the dosha exists in many padas, then it is a Vakya dosham. So for Vakya dosham, he gives the example of Tambula Bhrita Galloyam भल्लं जल्पति मानुषः करोति खादनं पानं सदैव तु यथा तथा. सो सम् वन् इस् टाकिङ्ग् इस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् ए पर्सन् हियर् एण्ड् हि सेस् दट् पर्सन्स् मौत् इस् फिल्ड् वित् बीटल् नट् ताम्बूलं. ताम्बूलभृत gallah, gallah means kapolah. His cheeks are filled with, you know, you see many people who are constantly chewing vetala, the paan leaves, and he is describing such a person who is constantly only eating that paan leaves, and just like how people eat and drink, just as how he also spends enough time, how much you will eat and drink, the same amount he has so much of paan leaves. So that is being described here in this shloka. So the words that he uses are very uncultured in the sense, I am manushaha, this man, instead of saying I am manavaha, I am janaha is a better expression than manushaha. I am manushaha. Tambula bhrita gallaha, his galla, his kapola, is filled, bhritam, is filled with puritam, tambulena puritaha kapolaha yasya saha. So tambula bhrita gallaha ayam bhallam jalpati. Bhallam jalpati, he is constantly talking some nonsense. Bhallam, kadanam karoti, panam karoti, sadaiva, yatha, tatha, ballam jalpati. Just like how he eats, khadanam karoti, panam cha karoti, and he drinks, in the same manner, bhallam jalpati, he also constantly keeps on saying something or the other. Right? When he has betel nuts in his mouth and he keeps talking, any words will not be clear. So that's why he uses the word bhallam jalpati, where it just keeps on talking nonsense there. Okay? Now here, atra ghalladayaha shabdaha. Now the words ghalla, bhalla, ghalla, balla, bhallam actually means samyak jalpati, but it's like samyak jalpati is probably not a dosha as far as when someone uses it in a hasirasa. In a Hasya Rasa, and some Gramya person is trying to describe a person who has betel nuts in his mouth or his red mouth, and he just eats and drinks and all that. But if the poet is of a high standard is a vidwan, and the person who is also talking in the kavyam is a vidwan, then he cannot use these words no matter what. Okay, so the words galla, bhalla for samyak, jalpati means actually he's talking nonsense, but here he is trying to convey the meaning of vadati. So vadati is not something that you use like that. Okay, so bhallam, galla balladayaha, so galla, bhalla, jalpana, and instead of using khadati and pibati, he says khadanam karoti, panam karoti. He does eating, he does, even in English it doesn't sound nice to say, you know, he does eating or he does drinking. Those are all not a nice usage of words or phrases. So this is an example of gramyatva dosha. Tambula bhrita galloyam bhallam jalpati manushaha karoti khadanam panam sadaivatu yatha tatha. The next dosha is neartha. Neartha we saw before is where which is based on lakshana. As far as lakshana goes in the chaturtho lasa, I'm just trying to refresh what you have read before in the first part. And in the lakshana, if a word has, if the word is a lakshaka shabda, there is a process called lakshana and there is a lakshyartha. The lakshyartha is the intended meaning. The lakshaka shabda is the word that gives rise to that intended meaning, and the process by which the meaning is given is called lakshana. Now this lakshana process has many steps involved in it. Number one, mukhyartha bada. The mukhyartha or your primary meaning is does not fit. The popular example I always take is Gangayam Goshaha, because repetition of popular examples will reinforce the idea in your mind very clearly. When we look at Gangayam Goshaha, the Ganga means the literal meaning of it, Vachyartha or the Mukhyartha is the Mukhyartha is Pravaha. So the Ganga Pravaha. Now this Ganga Pravaha is the Mukhyartha, and that does not fit properly. And if the Mukhyartha does not fit properly, then you go by association, you use, you look for some other meaning and you say Samipyam, and that Samipyam is the Sammandha, and that Sammandha gives rise to Ganga Tire. So Ganga Tire Tu Ghoshaha Bhavitum Arahati. So a village can exist on the banks of Ganga, and that Ganga Tiram is your Lakshyartha. For this, why am I using, instead of using Ganga Tira directly, I'm using Ganga as the primary word and the primary, the word itself in the shloka. And why I'm using that is so that it will give me the meaning of the prayojana, the use of that word is shaityam and pavanam. So when I use Ganga, the moment the word Ganga comes to the mind, shaityam or the coolness and the pavitratvam, pavanatvam also comes to the mind. So that is the prayojanam there. Or by popular convention like pankajam, etc., you can have pankata jayate, the something that comes from the muddy waters. It can be a worm or a lotus, but by popular convention, pankajaha, pankajam means only, not pankajaha, sorry, pankajam means only lotus. So by popular convention, the word pankajam indicates only lotus. Okay, now here, this sort of a prayojana or rudhi does not, if it does not exist, then that word is not a proper lakshana, but it is called neyartham and it is a dosha. So we saw only one word in the padagata dosham. Now in the vakyagata dosham, every word is going to be a problem. Now for this, let me just take up the tabular column, it's easier. So the shloka here is Vastra Vaidurya Charanaihi Kshata Sattva Rajavparaha Nishkampa Rajavpara Nishkampa Rachita Netra Yuddham Vedaya Sampratam. So someone is trying to wake up another person she's saying or he is saying the sun is up or the sun has removed the darkness from the earth. So open your eyes now. Sampratam Netra Yuddham Vedaya. The words he has used are completely different, which there is no popular convention to say this meaning has been conveyed by this word, nor is there a slesha used. There is no prayojanam also to use such a word. Let's look at those words. So Vastra Vaidurya Charanaihi. Now this Vastra Vaidurya Charanaihi, there are three words in that samasa. The first word is Vastram. Paryayavachi Shabda is Ambaram. So Ambaram, another word, you say Pitambaraha. Pitambaraha, Pitamambaram, Yasisaha. The one who wears a yellow cloth. So Vastram means cloth in English. The Paryayavachi Shabda is Ambaram. Now, Vastram cannot give us the meaning of Akasha directly, whereas Ambaram can also mean both Ambare Chandramaha Bhati and Ambare Suryaha Bhati. Ambaraha, Ambaram can mean both Vastram and Akasha. So here, because the word Ambara has two meanings, he has used the word Vastra to mean Akasha. If you look at it, Vastra actually has a paryayavachi word as only Ambara, not Akasha. Ambara has a paryayavachi. So the sambandha here is also only synonym. The synonymous words are only the sambandha and nothing else. Okay. So there is no prayojanam to it and nor any popular convention to give you that, this kavi has used Vastram as for Akasha, to indicate Akasha. There is no such indication also. Whereas Ambara Manihi is a word. Ambara is Akasha. Akashe yaha manihi vartate saha surya chandramaha. Anything can be used. Or Nisha Manihi is possible. Here Ambara Manihi is a usage that Dandin has used in his Dashakumara Charitam in several places in Dashakumara Charitam. So here, Vastra Vaidurya Charanaihi, Vastram is Ambaram, Vaiduryam is a type of money, so the Paryayavachi is money, and hence it is included. Ambaramani is Akashe Yaha Manihi Vidyate Saha Suryaha. Tasya Kiranaihi. Now, Kiranam is again Charana, actually means Pada. Pada is a word that can be used for Kirana, not Charana. Charana has never been used to indicate Kirana or the rays of the sun. So here, by the rays of the sun, we've got that word out. The next word is Kshata Sattva Rajav Para. Sattva Rajav Para is an adjective for Bhumihi. Now Nishkampa Bhumihi Kshata Sattva Rajav Para Jata. It has been rendered without any darkness. Now here, Rachita, Nishkampa, the Bhumi. Bhumi is Nishkampa, means Kamparahita. She does not move or there is no trembling in her, which means she is Achala. Achala is a word that is used for Bhumi. Achalaha is Bhudharaha, mountain, Parvatam. And Achala is a word that is being used for Bhumi. That is commonly found. Nishkampa is not a word that is used for Bhumi. So Nishkampa actually indicates Bhumihi. Nishkampa Bhumihi Kshata Sattva Rajav Para. Sattva Rajav Para means Sattva Rajobhyam Param. There are three gunas, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. The gunam that is beyond Sattva and Rajas is the Tamo gunam. Tamas also means Andhakara. So here, Tamaha, Sattva Rajobhyam, Sattva Rajav Para means Tamaha, Kshata Tamaha, Kshata Tamaha, Yasyaha Sa, Tadrishi. So she is the one whose darkness has been removed. Tamas is not, Tamo Gunam is not darkness as such. So tamaha is a word that is a paryayavachi or a synonym for andhakara, and hence he is used as sattvarajapara. If he had used kshatatamaha, then it is fine. There is no dosha there. Because he has used the word sattva rajav para, one which is beyond sattva and rajas guna, then it specifically says that it is only tamo gunam and not andhakaram. Using that, the poet tries to indicate that the tama here is sattva rajav para is actually andhakara, kshata andhakara. So nishkampa bhumihi kshata sattva rajav para rachita. It has been rendered prakasha, bright, or without any darkness. It has been made without any darkness. Now, so hence netra yuddham sampratam vedaya. Sampratam now, netra yuddham vedaya. Now the literal meaning, if you look at this, is the battle between two eyes. Vedaya means you understand, or vedaya, you understand the battle between two eyes. It will not even make any sense when we look at the literal meaning there. We have to go for the lakshyartha, and the lakshyartha has no use here, no prayojanam. Now, what is this yuddham? Yuddham is, there is a type of yuddha called dvandva yuddham, where two people fight with each other. So netra dvandvam means that will give you the meaning of netra dvayam, so two eyes. Sampratam, your two eyes. Vedaya, vedaya means bodhaya. Veti, one who knows. Vedayati, one who makes another person know. Nijanta, it is a causal form. Just like how I say pathati, one who reads. Pathayati is a person who makes someone read, or he teaches. In the same way here also, veti, a person who knows. Vedayati, he makes another person understand. Tasmat atra bodhayati iti arthe upayuktaha shabda. So vedaya iti arthe, what happens? Bodhaya. Bodhaya means also, it is a paryayavachi for waking up. Okay? So bodhayati, or opens, so which means udghatayati. Okay? Budhir, bodhane and avagamane. Both meanings are possible for buddha dhatu. So here avagamane is the meaning that actually is conveyed by vedaya. So vedaya, bodhaya, avagachati or avagamayati. And bodhanam also means waking up from something or opening something. So here, hence the lakshyartha becomes udghataya. Open your eyes. Open your two eyes. So here, there is no popular convention to determine that this is the meaning of the words given. There is no popular convention, nor is there a prayojanam for using such a type of expression or using these particular words. Okay. Now, atra ambara ratna padaihi kshata tama achala bhuhu krita. Netra dvandvam bodhaya iti neyarthata. So these are all the meanings that we get from the words that is given. It's easier if that tabular column is there. Hence, since there is no rudhi va prayojanam va nasti iti karanat atra neyarthatvam dosha. Next one is klishtatvam. Dhammillasya nakasya prekshya nikamam kuranga shavakakshyaha rajyati apurva bandha vipattehe manasam shobham. Here, klishtatvam, as we saw before, was atrilochana sambhutam. Atrilochana sambhutam was a term that was used for Chandra. And it was difficult to get to the meaning of that word. Another example I gave was Kshirodaja Vasati Bhuvah Prasannaha. Kshirodaja Vasati Bhuvah. So the residing place of Lakshmi is a lotus, and that lotus came from the water, and then the waters are clear. In order to say that Jalani Prasannani, I use this convoluted expression, that is klishtatvam. So here it is going to be the entire, now you can't look at many different words which are like that. Instead of that, the way the construct of the shloka is such that the vakyam itself is difficult to connect and give the meaning. Dhammillasya na kasya prekshya nikamam kurangashabakakshyaha. So the words are placed haphazardly up and down. So the anvaya of this entire shloka is very difficult. Now, kurangashabakakshyaha apurva bandha vyutpattehe dhammillasya shobham prekshya kasya manasam nikamam na rajyati. This is your anvayam here. Usually, when we do an anvaya for the shloka, we ask the students to, you know, or even when I was a student, we used to mark 1, 2, 3, 4 on each words that are there in that shloka to give us an indication of how the anvayam should be in a shloka. Generally, it's not so haphazard. So, if you look at the anvayam that has to go here, just for an example, I will try. Huh? So, kuranga shavakakshyaha is one, and then you will have apurva bandha vyutpattehe is here, two, dhammillasya is three, and then shobham is four, which is again down. So, one, two, and then three, four. Prekshya, again you have to go to the line before, 5, prekshya, kasya is 6 here, luckily he is set at the same place, then 7, manasam you have to come here, and then 8 is here, and then 9, rajyati is here. So if you look at it, for the anvaya, we have to go back and forth from the first line to the second line, that is your dosham here. This is very difficult. Anvaye yaha klishtatvam vartate padanam vyavadhana karanat padanam dure sthitatvat cha atra anvaye kleshaha vartate tasmat artha avagame api kleshaha vartate artha avagamasya vilamba karanat rasapratitehe api vilambaha. Hence the dosha is called klishtatvam. Let's look at the meaning of it. It's very simple. A lady, beautiful lady, kuranga shava kakshyaha. Kuranga shava is a small deer. Akshi, eyes. So she has beautiful eyes like the a small deer cub. And such a beautiful lady's dhammillasya, her hair arrangement is so beautiful that whoever who sees it, prekshya, upon seeing the beauty, shobham, of her hair arrangement, which has a very unique arrangement. Apurva bandha vyutpattehe dhammillasya. Dhammillaha is just hair, keshapasham. And keshapashasya atra apurva bandhaha krataha. Tasya bandhasya shobham drishtva prekshya kasya manasam narajyati. Whose mind will not be attracted by seeing the beauty of her hair. So this is a Nayaka who is trying to describe the beauty of the Keshapasha of his Nayika. So Kuranga Shavakakshyaha, Kasya Manasam, whose mind will not be happy or will not get attracted. Everybody's mind will get attracted. Narajyati, Prekshya, on seeing Kuranga Shavakakshyaha, the lady's unique, the beauty, Shobham, the beauty of the lady's apurva bandha vyutpatti, unique style of her hair arrangement, dhammillasya. Now this getting around this entire thing itself is tough. So that is why the artha, the dosham here is klishtatvam. So atra dhammillasya shobham prekshya kasya manasam na rajyati iti sambandhe klishtatvam. Okay, so that is your tough part here. 1 minute. Oh, I have to, I just got a message and I have to leave. I'm so sorry. I think I have to cut the class in short. I'll continue with the next one, next class, maybe on Thursday. I don't think we have class on Thursday. We will do it on Tuesday.